Hello everyone. So few days back, we provided the update for our extended plan subscribers on the topic of EMR big data cluster setup. I've also mentioned in that video that Amazon EMR is not free or not even available for a trial. For every second of your usage, you will have to pay some amount. So few of you wanted to know that if you want to do some hands-on on Amazon EMR, how much charges or bill you can expect from Amazon. So that session I have made last month, and by the end of the month I have got the bill for that. So I thought of discussing with you and show you all the breakup of the bill so that you can have an idea that how much bill you are going to get as per your usage. So let's see. I have logged into my AWS console. Although every time some bill is generated to you, you will get a mail as well. But anyways, if you want to see how much you are being charged. One more thing, whenever you create an Amazon EMR session and terminate it after your use, you will not be able to see the billing amount soon after that. It will take a couple of days to reflect on your dashboard. So go to your user ID and click on My Billing Dashboard. Here you can see zero charges because this is, here you can see current month to date balance. So this is for August. So here a small glimpse you can see, this is for current month, this is for previous month. So here you can see some amount because this is for last month when I created that Amazon EMR session for you. And this is a forecast. So just forget that for now. So this will show you only the current month. To see the previous charges, you can go to this bill section. And here you can select the month. So this is August selected. I was charged last month, so I'll go to July. And here you can see my amount was $0.69 or in Indian rupees 51.69. quite less, right? But yes, it is quite less, but I used this only for some minutes. We'll see how much that was, but this was only for your training purpose, so I didn't use it much. Now let us see how this 51.65 or 0.69 is justified. So summary is here. So this is the invoice and the charge was made from Amazon Internet Services Private Limited. Or in the mails you will also see some abbreviation AISPL. Even when they charge your credit card, in the statement you will see AISPL. So it might be not exactly Amazon, because some people get panicked, what is this AISPL charging me for? So that is Amazon only. Now here are the details. So total is 0.69. Now let's go one by one. First is data transfer. You can see a total amount is zero. So Amazon did not charge me anything for the data transfer. Even in that session, if you have seen, first of all, that is only available for extended plan subscribers. So all of you who have subscribed, if you have noticed, I tried to put some of the files over to HDFS as well. So I transferred some data, but Amazon did not charge me anything for that. But the good thing is it even explains what charges were there, or the data that was transferred. So you can see for some of the files it is showing me the data as well. 0.00034 1.187 GB or something. So all this data transfer could be whatever EMR cluster you have built, onto that you are putting some data, or obviously it is a EMR cluster, so it is distributed. So it even counts the data transfer between the nodes as well. But anyways, as per plan, they are not going to charge us for that. That plan can differ as per different organizations, what package or plan they are taking, or it is a customized cluster. So just you can have a small idea that these are the components that might charge you. First was data transfer. Now let's come to Elastic Compute Cloud. That is EC2 that I have explained in that session. So here you can see a total of 0.49. So let's see how that is calculated. So first is 0.00 per Linux T2 micro. So as I told you, my website gkcodelabs.com is also running on the same account, and that is also running on one of the EC2 instance. So this is for that, because that instance is T2 micro type. So in that session I have also explained there are multiple instance types. The one on which my website is running, that is T2 micro, and that is free. So there are no charges for that. So EC2 micro is free for 1 year. After that you will start getting charged. So EC2 T2 micro instance is free, but it has limited resources, but it is free for 1 year. After that only you will start getting charged. So this you can see is the total hours for this amount. So it is free for 743 hours per month. So around 750, that is close to entire month if you can calculate. So 24 into 30, so close to 720. So it is free for 743 hours per month. So this is total, not the hours being used. Obviously my website is running 24/7, so these will be used, but this is the total one. So for this amount, T2 micro instance, they are charging me nothing, because obviously for 1 year it is free. Now coming to second one, this is Linux MX Large. So here is what we used for EMR. So this is instance R, and as you know, we created a cluster for three nodes. So for master and local, even I saw that they have different way of computing the total total bill. So you can see one is reflected here and other is reflected inside Elastic MapReduce. So our three node cluster is distributed here. I don't know how they are doing it. Although total charge was 0.048 per hour for MX large cluster. So if you go for charges, sorry, M5X large charges, that is what we are billed for, M5X large. So this is 0.048 per hour. So same way, 0.048 per hour, and this is charged for 0.09. So for two of the nodes, it's coming inside the Elastic MapReduce. So 0.048 into 2. So 0.09. This is coming here, and one of the node is coming here. So one node, 0.48 or 49, they have calculated in the different section. But I believe this will be same, because nowhere else we used M5X large. So totally for three nodes we are being charged, and I used this cluster for two different time spans, but it was close to under 1 hour. So that is why total charges are near about same, 0.048 into 3. So into 2 is here and into 1 is here. So that was for EMR. Now let's see what else. Key management service. So as in that video, I have also explained how you can generate EC2 key pairs. So that also we have generated, but you can see they are not charging for that also. Simple queue service, simple storage service, that as well, no charges. And one more thing, in Elastic Compute Cloud, you can see this EBS storage. This component is also very important. This is the storage that you are using, on which you are putting the data. So you can see this total is 8.25 GB month. That means per month this much of data. But our cluster has even more. So that storage is not calculated separately for EMR cluster. So this is the storage that I am getting for this T2 micro instance. For this obviously it is free, so no charges. But there is no separate storage charge for EMR. So that is all included in this M5X large. So computation power, storage power, everything is included in this. That is why the charge are a little bit higher. So whatever you are seeing here, 0.048, everything, the processing, and as per the memory, so almost 16 GB memory we got per node. So all the computation, CPU resources, storage, and the memory, everything is included in this. Just for the node and hour, I had to pay. So this all. And on to that, GST was applicable for 0.11. So this total to 0.69. That is 51.65. That is also whenever you are getting billed, whatever the current rate will be there, accordingly you will be charged. Now coming to payment, you will get a sort of mail from Amazon that this is the charge for this month. So they will give you a deadline that by this time you can pay it. Otherwise, while creating this AWS account, you would have put your default credit or debit card. So that will be automatically charged after that date limit. So that is how it works. So for my case, it was less, because I knew how to configure it, how to test it, everything, put the data, and suppose if I want to try something out. That is for personal, like if for production level project, this doesn't concern you obviously, But for now, when you are going through all the tutorials, if you want to try some code out, for that case, if you are planning, so here you can see for almost 1 hour I used, I got a bill of 51 rupees, not much. So you can try, and this was the breakup I have explained. But yeah, sure, if you forget this and if you forget to terminate, you can see according to this where your bill can go. In my opinion, if you be a little bit careful, this is not going to be much. So that's all for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned to GK Code Labs.